One Marmite, one jam. Breakfast and pudding. I have been so excited to start this project, and I'm going to have to start it soon before I eat all these sweets. I have got an amazing brass-legged marble top table. I've had a nest of three of them for years. They're not great tables now. They were back in their day. Take a look at that. I'm going to take this extremely heavy marble piece out. I'm going to clean that up and possibly use that as a chopping board here, actually, for making my jam on toast. And my plan is to take this off so the scalloped area is facing down, so that I've still got the beautiful finish. But what that's given me then is given me a dead flat new tabletop that is going to blow your mind. So by turning the brass surround of this table upside down and inserting a wooden base, I'm creating a new sealed tabletop. On top of this base, the sweets are going to be forever on display using one part hardener and one part epoxy resin mix. These are to buff up your actual nails. So if they're not scratching your nails, they're going to be fine on the brass. I find it gets off the dirt and grime much quicker. It's one of my favourite little tips. No magic. Camera's still on. Look, can you see already? I know, right? I can hear you all going. I'm in the process of turning my balcony into like an extension of the lounge. It's just not getting used enough at the moment. Dave can have that one, do his nails. So I've got a vision in my head of a nice romantic little space watching the sun go down.
Right, back to the table. I've already cut a piece of plywood to size that's going to form a solid base.
Because obviously I don't want any of my resin to fall through the bottom. So I'm going to make sure it's really sealed all around the edges.
For this, I'm using just a standard bathroom sealant.
So I thought of using some colourful wrapping paper, but it's going to show some colour through anywhere there's gaps in the sweets.
Going to get it as central as possible. Yes.
Let's do the sweets. I'd always get extra because you're definitely going to eat some. How colourful is that? So I'm going through, taking out all the high sweets because I want the resin to completely cover it. Like this one, it's too big. Let's have a look. Oh, look how colourful that is, though. Okay. I could see that. The best memory I have was this sweet shop on the way to school, and we all used to go there. This really old couple owned it, and they had an Alsatian dog that used to sit in the shop, and there used to be dog hairs in the sweets, and you used to get quarter of... It was a crumble. It was something crumble, and basically, it was like crumbled up Twix and Mars. It was amazing, and you used to get your shrimps from there, but God, when you look back, it was a really old shop. They probably weren't that old, actually, but when you're young, you think everyone's really old.
Now for the science bit. To hold the sweets in place, I'm mixing epoxy resin with a hardener, which, when set, should give the tabletop the appearance of glass with the sweets under the surface.
Here we go. The point of no return. I'm going to pour the resin in, and I hope all the sweets stay still. I hope none rise to the top. I hope none start fizzing. I hope there's no bubbles. So, are you ready? Yes! Oh, I don't want to do it. So, a couple of years ago, I was offered a whole shop full of mannequins, and I said, yes, we'll have them, because at the time, I didn't do anything with mannequins. I just worked on furniture, but I just knew they could be really helpful, very handy. And so what I did, I started to split them down. So I take the hands off, the arms off, the legs off, the bodies off, and I started to create things from every part of that mannequin. Today I'm going to show you what you can do with the hands.
To create some simple and stylish wall-mounted lights, I'm first going to attach the mannequin hands to a round wooden base and spray paint them in bright, funky colours before powering up some amazing sculpted oversized bulbs.
Okay, brackets. My favourites are what are called flush mounts, which would go, that would be on the wall, and then this would slide in. Lovely, there we go. That's how easy it is. It really is that easy. There's so many different wirings you can get. So what I do is I just fashion them now. Like, you can have them different heights. This is one. Right, let's get some bulbs. I think we'll have, should we mix it? I'm gonna put this blue, bluey green one on the blue hand. And this is what I mean about nice bulbs. Look at the color of that. And you don't need a shade then. So. Bunch of grapes. And so it's time to power these beauties up. I am extremely happy with those. And I'm glad I did my little touch of light pink. I think you can see that that is a really good project to do at home. Why would you want to chuck that away? When you can have that. You know, why would you not want that on your wall? My sweet treat tabletop is really starting to take shape. Now for the moment of truth, pouring in the resin. Hopefully I've sealed the base well enough, but what I'm really nervous about is sweets floating to the top, because once it starts to set, there'll be no going back. So are you ready? To do it. Here we go. I'm making sure to pour this in carefully so that no resin spills over the edge. Removing it will ruin the finish. How satisfying is that? I've gone over the edge. There's a leak here. There's literally resin everywhere. It needs to start setting soon, though. If that's leaked, that's the end of the table. See what happens. I must leave it.
Set a timer for 4 hours, Dave.
Oh, yes. I'm happy with that. I was really worried about this because I did start to see a bit of leaking where I hadn't sealed it fully, but I've been very lucky. Let's go and get this on my balcony. Well, doesn't that just look a sweet treat? I'm really happy to be able to use this table again because I've always loved this brass work, but I hated that marble. It just did not fit my look in the house. The fact that I could repurpose it and make it look so different and so cool, I've absolutely loved making this. It looks really good, it's sturdy, and wow, doesn't it look fabulous?
Cheers.